Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? O'er the land of the free,
here's what you came for. This is the moment magic was made for. Come one, come all, let's light up the sky now. You feel the magic happening right now.
Yeah. gentlemen, please welcome Miss America's Teen 2024, Hanley House. Stand and greet your Miss America 2023, Grace Stanky.
Heart of the enchanting Walt Disney Theater, right here in the Dr. Phillips Performing Arts Center, surrounded by the magic of Orlando, Florida. Welcome to an evening we promise to be filled with poise, inspiration, and unforgettable moments. In fabulous fashions provided by our official fashions partner, Giovanni, please welcome the 51 delegates who are ready to grace this stage with their intelligence, charisma, and unwavering commitment to service on the road to becoming Miss America 2024.
From the rocket heights of Huntsville down to the sandy beaches of the Gulf Coast, I'm Miss Alabama, Brianna Burrell. From the state with the coldest weather but the warmest hearts, I am your Miss Alaska, Hannah Unick. From the state that has it all from A to Z, I am Miss Arizona, Tiffany Ticklow. From the rice and duck capital of the world, I'm Miss Arkansas, Corey Keller. Representing the Golden State, I am Miss California 2023, Sabrina Lewis. Coming to you from the home of the Air Force Academy where the sky is not the limit, I am Miss Colorado, Madison Marsh. Coming to you from the state where oysters are plenty, tonight we're turning pressure into pearls. I am Miss Connecticut, Gina Carlotto. Home to over 60% of Fortune 500 companies and with state parks voted America's best, the first state can do it all. I am proud to be Miss Delaware, Emily Beal. From the city with over 160 memorials but just one monument, I'm Miss District of Columbia, Jude Mabonet. From the state that brings you the beautiful beaches of Miami to the magic of Orlando, I am Juliet Bai, Miss Florida. From the Blue Ridge to the beaches, there is nothing sweeter than Georgia peaches. From the state that is always on your mind, I am Miss Georgia, Tara Lynn Shipoff. From the Aloha State, I'm Miss Hawaii, Stardoll Thurston. With the only state seal in all 50 states to be designed by a woman, I am Reagan Yamauchi, your Miss Idaho. Representing the pumpkin capital of the world, the land of Lincoln and home to the Chicago Bears, I am Miss Illinois, Jessica Tilton. Coming to you from the birthplace of the legend Michael Jackson, I promise I am thrilled to be here as Jorbis, Indiana, Sydney Bridges. Is this heaven? No, it's Miss America. Representing fields of dreamers like me, I am Miss Iowa, Alyssa Gothy. Home to Amelia Earhart, Hattie McDaniel, and hopefully your next Miss America, I am Courtney Wages, Miss Kansas. From the home of the best 2 minutes in sports, I'm ready to run for my roses. I'm Miss Kentucky, Mallory Hudson. Proudly representing Sportsman's Paradise and the only state to have parishes, I am Miss Louisiana, Mackenzie Scroggs. bringing a little rainbow to the Sunshine State, I am your Miss Maine, Veronica Druzhniak.
From the cybersecurity capital of the nation and the state with the best crab cakes, I am your Miss Maryland, Kennedy Taylor.
The shot heard around the world to the invention of basketball, this Commonwealth has it all. I am Chelsea Baum, Miss Massachusetts.
Coming to you from where the lakes are great, but so are the people, I am Miss Michigan, Maya Sutnick.
Representing the land of over 10,000 lakes, I'm Angelina Marigo, Miss Minnesota.
From the state that taught us the universal way to count, one Mississippi, two Mississippi, I'm Miss Mississippi, Vivian O'Neill.
From Mark Twain to the Great Plains, this Show Me State girl is going to show you the magic of Miss America.
From Missouri, I am Haley Leach.
From the state where I'm literally one in a million, I'm Miss Montana, Faith Johnson. From the state with the greatest fans holding the world record for attendance at a women's sports event, I am Miss Nebraska, Morgan Baird.
From the first state in the nation to elect a female majority legislature, I'm here to girl boss on the Miss America stage tonight. I'm Taylor Blatchford, Miss Nevada.
With the state motto of live free or die, we mean business about liberty and the pursuit of the American dream. I'm your Miss New Hampshire, Dr. Brooke Mills.
From the state that brought you Frank Sinatra, American baseball, Monopoly, and our favorite, Miss America.
Doing it my way, I'm Miss New Jersey, Victoria Mosaitis.
From White Sands to Carlsbad Caverns, I'm proud to be from the land of enchantment.
I am Leanna Hartshorn, your Miss New Mexico.
Coming to you from the state where your dreams can become a reality, I'm Miss New York, Amelia Collins.
Advocating the arts connection for our veterans from the home of the world's largest military base, I am Miss North Carolina, Taylor Lloyd.
From our oil to our soil, representing the state that fuels and feeds the world, I am Miss North Dakota, Sydney Helgeson.
I am proud to be from the state with the only National Veterans Memorial and Museum. I am your Miss Ohio, Madison Miller.
Where the wind comes sweeping down the plains, I always try to bring a little bit of sunshine. I am Sunny Day, Miss Oklahoma.
From the state where you can travel from the beach to the mountains to the desert all in one day, I'm Allison Burke, Miss Oregon.
From the birthplace of Taylor Swift and living my own wildest dreams, I am Miranda Moore, Miss Pennsylvania.
With over 400 miles of coastline, how's this for a wave?
I'm Miss Rhode Island, Caroline Parenti.
From the home state of legendary EGOT winner, Viola Davis, I'm here as a storyteller with a vision of bringing home another coveted award. I'm Miss South Carolina, Jada Samuel.
Coming to you from the Mount Rushmore state where we're known for great places and great faces, this is a face you'll want to remember. I am Miranda O'Brien, Miss South Dakota.
Coming to you straight from Music City and the proud home of country music, I am Brandy Mills, Miss Tennessee.
Coming from the fourth largest city in the nation, Houston, we have a problem, but only if I don't come home with the crown. I am Ellie Bro, Miss Texas.
As a daughter of Chinese immigrants, I'm proud to represent a state settled by pioneers and refugees. Coming to you as Miss Utah, I am Sarah Sun.
Fish food, coffee, coffee, buzz, buzz, home of Ben and Jerry's, the best ice cream in the nation. I'm Miss Vermont, Yamona Turco.
Did you know that Virginia is for lovers? From our mountains, valleys, and beaches, here to show you all of my love tonight, I am Katie Rose, Miss Virginia.
From the home state of Starbucks, I'll be your pick-me-up America. I'm Miss Washington, Vanessa Munson.
Oh, the places I'll go, but country roads will take me home. Proudly representing Almost Heaven, I'm Miss West Virginia, Carrington Childress.
Ice cream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream.
From the state that eats more than 21 million gallons of ice cream per year, I am Miss Wisconsin, Lila Cherry.
Representing the Cowboy State, it's Mackenzie Kern, Miss Wyoming.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Miss America 2024!
Welcome to everybody watching at home and to everybody here in the Walt Disney Theater. Are you ready? name is Nikki Novak, joined by...
I am Terrence J. I had to come out with my shades on because there's so much bling behind me. Everybody, please give it up for all of our delegates here tonight. And please, make some noise for my co-host, Nikki. How excited are you?
I am so excited to be here with you all. I can tell we're going to have a fun night. Are you ready to get this party started? All right, let's do this.
All right, let's step into our office. You know the hashtag for social media. It's hashtag there she is, because there they are. Behind us, the 51 delegates from across the nation that are vying for the honor of representing the modern woman in America. The stage is full of glamorous, intelligent, and charismatic women
who are talking about me? Of course, you're in the mix.
They're bringing back the magic of Miss America, the iconic Miss America. But it seems as though we're missing something, or maybe we're missing someone. Since 2017.
Oh, yes. Well, it is a very big stage here at the Dr. Phillips Center, and I think we can add more for 2025. So, we are excited to announce that Miss Puerto Rico and Miss Puerto Rico's teen will return to the stage for the Miss America competition in 2025. Yes!
I love it. I love it. Listen, this room is full of so much energy. As soon as my agents called me, they was like, Robin, they called you. They want you to do Miss America. I'm like, I'll do it. I will be there because I know that the energy in this room is going to be electrifying. Yeah. But with that said, the time has come. Right now, we're going to narrow down the playing field from 51 down to 11. But before we do that, Nikki, let's break down the scoring.
Okay, here's how it's gonna go. Each semifinalist will compete in all four phases of competition: fitness, onstage question, talent, and evening gown, which are now weighted at 25% across each board. After that, we will turn the 11 semifinalists into five finalists who will answer a final question on stage.
So the 10 semifinalists have been chosen by the preliminary judges. And guess what? One has been chosen by you, America, in America's Choice voting, all right? And the exciting part is whatever's happened this week during the preliminary rounds, it's all up for grabs tonight. The 11 semifinalists all have an equal opportunity to take home the crown tonight.
So we will announce all 11 names without disclosing who is America's choice. But you can go to missamerica.org after the competition to find out who she is, which makes for a very exciting competition, don't you guys think?
So with that said, before we narrow it down to the top 11, I have one question for the audience.
Okay, go for it.
Does anybody in here happen to know who's gonna win this thing tonight? Does anybody happen to have an idea of who's gonna take it home? Anybody?
I can't hear you.
I see Colorado thinks Colorado. That it's gonna be Colorado.
Pennsylvania Oklahoma.
Seems to think that it's gonna be Pennsylvania. Oklahoma, yeah. Allison, you see it, it's crazy. What is that? What is this, is that VA, is that? NC, I don't know what this is.
New Hampshire.
YMCA is not a state. I don't know what this means.
Wow.
What is that? Okay, we'll talk about it. Okay, I'll come over there
later.
Okay.
Okay, we got it.
All right.
I think we got it.
Security, keep your eyes on section 103.
Yeah.
They're going crazy.
They're rowdy up there.
Those guys are, they are wild. Keep your eyes secure. Watch out for them.
Okay.
Going crazy up there.
All right, I think we've kept you waiting long enough. So let's see if your favorites made the judges' list. Please join us in welcoming Alice Filippone and our auditors from EY who have the results. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Allison. Now, just so you know, Allison and her team have been working diligently all week. These are confidential. We have not seen these before, and it is time to announce your top 11 semifinalists in competition order. Nikki.
Are you guys ready? The first semifinalist. You know, here's a hint. Every time I go to that state, I have big hair. You know what I'm talking about? Texas! Miss Texas! Ellie Pro!
Right now, we're gonna take a trip to my home state, actually. And if you don't know where that is, I'm kinda wearing the color tonight. The Carolina blue. Let's take a trip to North Carolina. Taylor Lloyd. Miss North Carolina.
Congratulations to you both. The next semifinalist competing for Miss America 2024 is, I'm just gonna give this to you straight, Miss Indiana, Sydney Bridges!
Ladies and gentlemen, there's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. Let's go to Kansas, Miss Kansas, Courtney Wages.
What you did there, so I'm just gonna keep going with that. Anybody like to ski? Anybody like to ski? Then you're gonna like this one. Miss Colorado, Madison Marsh.
Colorado KD. All right. Let's stay on the semi, let's stay on the East Coast with the next semifinalist. Does anybody know where it is? Anybody have an idea? Ladies and gentlemen, let's take a trip to Maryland. Miss Maryland Kennedy Taylor has made the top 11.
Congratulations, our next semifinalist. Do you like the hints? Do you like the hints? I hear both. Okay. Well, she didn't have to travel very far for this. Miss Florida, Juliet Baez!
Once again, for the past week, all of these young women have gone through vigorous challenges to be narrowed down to the top 11. So again, thank you guys so much. I'm starting to feel the pressure mount. Right now, it's time to announce the next semifinalist, which is Miss Rhode Island, Caroline Parente.
Come on down, Miss Kentucky, Mallory.
right now, I'm more nervous than a ninth grader on the first day of high school. We are narrowing this thing down. Do y'all feel the pressure? Does anybody else in here feel the pressure? You feel the pressure. You feel the pressure. He feels the, what's your name? What is it? Abraham feels the pressure.
Well, I think I know Abraham. Mr. Giovanni.
All right.
He's feeling the pressure.
He feels the pressure. All right. Right now, it's time to take a trip because we feel the pressure. So let's go to Arkansas with Miss Arkansas, Tori Keller. Oh my goodness.
Semi-finalist for Miss America 2024.
I gotta get some.
Okay. Whew. Take a breather. Okay. Thank you. Oh yeah.
It's hot in here.
Do you need one too?
It's hot in here.
Man. Well, you know what they say about this place? If you can make it there, you can make it anywhere. Miss New York, Amelia Collins.
Congratulations, Miss New York.
Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, there they are. Your semifinalists for the title of Miss America 2024. Congratulations, ladies. Please take the runway. And have your moment. Bask in it. And while they are on the runway,
amazing.
Yep,
amazing.
I would also like to take this time to congratulate the 40 remaining delegates. They all, please, ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for the 40 remaining delegates. Thank you all so much. All of the hard work, all of the incredible work, everything that you put into it, thank you so much to all of the other 40 delegates. What an amazing ride.
Amazing. Okay, the ladies have gone backstage and we will see them again shortly. They're getting ready for the fitness competition. So let's take some time to introduce our incredible panel of judges. To add even more mystery and excitement to the competition, we have a panel who is exclusively judging the final competition. And let me tell you, they are bringing a wealth of knowledge and experience from a vast array of backgrounds.
Absolutely. We're going to start things off with an entrepreneur, author, and businesswoman. She's also a public speaker. Our first judge is recognized for her dynamic approach in various industries. She's the co-founder of Cardone Capital, a multi-billion dollar real estate investment firm, alongside her husband, Grant Cardone. She's also known for her advocacy for women's empowerment, which she addresses in her book, Build an Empire, How to Have It All, and is now the CEO of Build an Empire and 10X Ladies. She is also the proud wife and mother to two beautiful daughters. Please welcome Elena Cardone.
Our next judge relocated from Alabama to New York City at age 18 to pursue a modeling career. She quickly got snatched up by Wilhelmina Models and her career took off. Her very first booking was the cover of the highest selling Essence magazine in history. Her next move was to Paris and Milan, where she could be seen strutting down the runways at Paris and Milan Fashion Week. After that, she came back to New York City, landing campaigns for Maybelline, Oil of Olay, and Macy's, magazine editorials for Vogue, Glamour, Elle, Essence, and Vanity Fair soon followed. Over the years, she'd become a very recognized face for Neiman Marcus, Bergdorf Goodman, Lord & Taylor, Nordstrom, Saks Fifth Avenue, Talbots, Macy's, and Target. She was also in high demand for music videos, commercials, and even co-starred in the film Without You, I'm Nothing. These days, she's added the titles of CEO and entrepreneur to her resume. Her next chapter is all about focusing on her acting career, and I love this, living her best life. Please welcome the incredible Cynthia Bailey.
Cynthia. Now, our third judge tonight is a celebrated global events and wedding planner and fashion designer, entrepreneur, floral designer, author, and TV star. He's recognized as one of the top planners in the U.S. in numerous publications and honored by Life and Style magazine as the best celebrity wedding planner. His impressive client list includes both celebrities and non-celebrities, and he's created spectacular events for stars like Jewel, Shannon Dorothy, Jennifer Lopez, and Matthew McConaughey, and many, many more, as well as countless film premieres and celebrity parties for royalty, politicians, and socialites. Please welcome David Totora. And David, you know, I got engaged recently, so I'm gonna come to you later and talk about the discount, all right? My fiance is up in, baby, how you doing, baby? My fiance is up in the top waving.
There she is.
Baby.
There she is.
There she is.
Hashtag there she is. Okay. Founder and CEO of Vitamina, our next judge is an accomplished businesswoman and entrepreneur driven by an unwavering passion to help others live their healthiest lives. With a successful career in marketing and brand development, she founded a global advertising agency, which she later sold to follow her true passion in the health and wellness industry. Her new venture, Vitamina, is an innovative personalized supplement and wellness brand providing effective supplements and educating and inspiring individuals to make positive lifestyle choices. She's an avid supporter of the American Heart Association and a board member of Florida's renowned Big Dog Ranch Rescue, among her other philanthropic interests. Please welcome Susan Malzone.
Thank you, Susan. Now, our next judge is a beauty industry veteran, having been a model, beauty queen, and co-host. She is also the author of A Model's Secrets and currently part of Ford Models. At 50, with three teens at home approaching college age, she decided to take a different career path. She embraced entrepreneurship and founded Hidden Crown, which is a user-friendly hair extension brand based in Tucson, Arizona. 10 years in, it has grown into an eight-figure beauty e-commerce business that has seen the likes of celebrities like Kim and Khloe Kardashian, J-Lo, Real Housewives, and models like Gigi Hadid, and many more. From her life experiences, she incorporates it into a company message of empowerment and motivation to follow your inner dreams and beauty of aging from the inside out. Please welcome Shelly Goodstein. I got you, Shelly.
I like your passion
Thank
there.
Thank you so much. I got
I
you.
Like your passion there,
I'm
too.
I'm passionate. She does some good yeah. work.
Okay.
Work.
Our sixth and final judge this evening has been described as the leader of the global breast cancer movement. Her journey began with a promise to her dying sister, Susan G. Komen, that she would do everything possible to end the pain, fear, and hopelessness caused by the disease and establish the Susan G. Komen Foundation. Her accomplishments led Time Magazine to name her one of the 100 most influential people. She was named Goodwill Ambassador for Cancer Control for the United Nations World Health Organization, where she continues her mission to put cancer control at the top of the World Health Agenda. She's received numerous accolades for her global work, including the CDC's Champions of Excellence Award, the Forbes Trailblazer Award, and was included in the Ladies Home Journal's 100 Most Important Women of the 20th Century list. In 2015, she was inducted into the National Women's Hall of Fame, and in 2010, she released her New York Times best-selling memoir, Promise Me, an inspirational story of her transformation from bereaved younger sister to the undisputed leader of the ongoing international movement to end breast cancer. Please give a big round of applause for Nancy G. Brinker.
Nancy. Nancy, thank you so much. Thank you to all of our judges for spending your time here. We really appreciate you. You guys have the hardest job here tonight.
Absolutely.
Trust me.
And I'm in awe of all of you. Thank you for joining.
Absolutely. But also with a very difficult job, we would like to recognize the auditing team at EY for once again taking on the task of ensuring fairness in our scoring. There's no funny business going on when it comes to taking that score tonight. They are watching everything like a hawk. They got the security, the Secret Service back there.
Yeah.
All of those envelopes are top secret. Okay, so
but
thank
you so much.
They're smiling.
They're smiling, so it's good.
Because they know it.
I feel
they
good
know
about it.
It.
Yeah, they know. They have the power right now. They're like, yeah, yeah, we all know something you don't. All right, well, we very much appreciate you and this incredible panel of judges. Thank you all for being here. All right, now get ready because these talented and charismatic ladies are not going to make your job very easy, and you're in for a treat, audience.
Absolutely. And we are here for night two. Last night was amazing. All right. Right here on this very stage, we got introduced to a dynamic young lady from North Carolina who won the hearts of judges and walked away with the title of Miss America's Teen Crown. So before we begin Miss America competition tonight, let's meet her again. Your Miss America's Teen 2024, please welcome Hanley House.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
How are you is the question. Oh my goodness, what an exciting night that was.
It was incredible. I'm still dreaming. Please don't wake me up. I'm still dreaming.
Okay, I have to ask. Yeah, do you remember the moment? I mean, we got to call your name and it was absolutely electric in here. Do you remember the moment? What was it like?
Wow, I think I jumped around 10 feet off the ground. I was in total shock. I do not remember what went through my mind other than literally, I thought I was in a dream. It was an incredible moment. And as you can tell, I'm speechless because I still can't believe it.
We can believe it.
Absolutely. Well, let's say the hard work begins tomorrow, right? Today, you can take a sign of relief. But for the young ladies that are competing today, what do you think's the biggest challenge? What was the hardest part of the competition last night?
Ooh, that's a hard one. I think maybe the hardest part of the competition, maybe towards the end, you know, just to keep going and to keep uplifting yourself and to keep keep that positive mindset. You know, it's been a long week, but we're thriving and we're having the best time. And so staying positive and keeping that incredible mindset is really important.
Yeah, can you talk a little bit about that? Because I've got to spend some time with you all backstage rehearsing, and the thing that I noticed the most was that energy, the hugs, the laughter. I almost forgot that there was a competition going on. Like, it really just felt like a bunch of young women just having fun.
Right. I'm so thankful that they added the fifth pillar to the Miss America opportunity, sisterhood, because that cannot be more true. I was able to make 50 more best friends this week, and I'm so thankful for that opportunity. I'm sure they're out there. I'm so thankful for them. It was an incredible opportunity just to meet all of the different states and just to be able to gain even more sisters.
And you're going to be doing some incredible work this year. What are you looking forward to most?
I'm so excited just to be able to grow the Miss America opportunity and spread my business plan and passion to profit. You know, I'm really passionate about passion to profit, and I cannot wait to continue to, you know, spread it even more in the nation.
I saw a picture on social media of you with your family celebrating after, and they were just glowing. Do you want to talk about sort of that moment, sharing that moment with your family for the first time?
That is a moment that I will remember for the rest of my life, you know, seeing my mom and dad and my family and all of my supporters, you know, being able to go on my phone after and see all of the watch parties and all of the videos from all of my friends screaming at home just made my heart so incredibly happy. And, you know, it just makes me so thankful for this opportunity because it's really what it's all about. You know, the Miss America opportunity changes lives, and I'm thankful to be here today.
Well, we are so proud of you. Congratulations once again.
Thank you. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for your Miss America's Teen 2024, Hanley House. Okay, Hideki, how are you feeling?
I feel good. How do you feel?
I feel good. You got this side. How is this side feeling? I want to make sure we check in with the audience and make sure everybody's feeling good. How's everybody feeling over here?
Okay.
Man, are we feeling good, man? Are we? Is everybody at home feeling good? Are you feeling good at home? Good, good.
Okay.
This side
can't outdo this side. I want to hear from this side. Up
you know
in the
who,
balcony.
Yeah, who makes the most noise is
the
everybody
balcony.
In the balcony. Yeah. Because when you're up in the balcony, you got nothing to lose. When you're
I
up
know.
There, you just go crazy.
I
That's
know.
What it is.
I heard up there they take their shoes off.
Listen, upstairs is the party.
Yeah, there's a party going on up there.
And tonight is a sold out night. Every single seat is filled. And
yeah.
The entire show was sold out in 2 hours. So please give yourself a round of applause.
Yeah. Big
We're
accomplishment
so
there. They were fast. These people in this room are fast. They were not missing this night. So, you know, we haven't heard from you since we have our 11 semifinalists. So who do you think is going to win now?
All right. Well, you know what time it is, Nikki.
Without
further ado, let's get this competition on the road.
All right.
Okay. Showcasing their commitment to a healthy lifestyle as they stride confidently across the stage, modeling the latest in fitness fashion provided by our fantastic partners at Rebel Athletic. Here are your 11 semifinalists in the fitness competition.
Yeah. de show. On t'invite à la magie, y a pas de raccourci. Oublie tes soucis, c'est bien faire la folie.
On t'invite à la magie, y a pas de raccourci. Oublie tes soucis.
Oh, oh, oh. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Colorado, Madison Marsh. Moment. We're in Florida. Stand up. Let's make some noise. Stand up.
Get your fitness on.
Welcome.
Burn those calories.
Exactly. Okay, are you guys ready? Because being Miss America is not just about looking pretty. It's about being fit.
Yes, talk to them about it. You're fit.
I'm fit. Can we turn the dance music back on for one more second? Turn the dance music on. Everybody here wants to dance one moment.
All right.
Let's party. Everybody put your hands up.
Welcome to Miss America. I like this. I like this. We just got to dance a little longer. I call this a little intermission. It's a little intermission. It's a little intermission for the judges. A little intermission.
Stop it.
I'm sorry.
All right.
I'm sorry.
All right.
I was feeling. We're in. You know, in Florida, we gotta party
gotta
a little
move.
Bit.
You yeah, move. I'm sweating. Oh, yeah, a little sweat happening.
Okay. Let's get back to.
All right. Being hashtag Miss America Fit is a lifestyle, as you can see, not just a look, because fitness looks different on everyone. So thank you again to our partner, Rebel Athletic. Rebel Activewear is not just a statement, it's a symbol of empowerment, resilience, my heart's still pounding, and unstoppable spirit.
Yeah, I didn't realize how out of shape I was until I danced for 3 minutes straight. I'm sweating. Now, would you agree that the competition is heating up? Because that's how I feel. So who is everybody rooting for again tonight? You know, we have had the absolute best time here in Orlando. They have welcomed us with open arms. So please, let's take a look at the delegates arriving here in the Old Town for the competition.
And we'll catch our breath.
Absolutely.
Be able to snag two of the best choreographers in the country for the preliminary show and the finals, Mikey Pesante and Rudy Garcia. Their client list is so very impressive. I mean, here, listen to this list. We're talking about Rihanna, Joe Jonas, Camila Cabello, Jennifer Lopez, and that is just to name a few. And Mikey is currently scouting for The Voice. Can you sing?
I cannot sing, but I try. Okay. In the shower, I'm amazing.
Let's hear it.
We're not in the shower.
We got good acoustics in here.
We'll talk about that a little later.
All right. Well, thank you, Mikey and Rudy, for helping make our show such a success. Check out their full resumes on Miss America's Facebook page and the IG Instagram.
Ooh, yeah. No, sorry. I'm soft launch. All right. We would also like to give a huge thank to our new fashion partner, Giovanni, for bringing back the magic of Miss America, all right? They had all of the dresses, they provided them for the gorgeous opening number for all 102 delegates competing this week. That's a lot of dresses and a lot of sparkle. In addition to all of the preliminary evening gown awards, they were sponsored by Giovanni. So again, thank you so much. Again, I'm engaged, so if you want to send some dresses to us, we can talk about it backstage. Thank you.
And the new Miss America has the opportunity this coming year to attend Giovanni's New York Fashion Week and be dressed by the brand for her appearances across the country. Go to Giovanni.com and check out their exclusive designs. But just a warning, you're going to want everything. I've been there. I'm wearing Giovanni tonight. Thank you to Giovanni and thank you to my fairy godmothers at Henry's who dressed me for every occasion. I wouldn't have anybody else dress me. Thank you all very much. And thank you again to Giovanni.
They're the real deal. Okay, moving on with the competition. Next up is the onstage conversation. All right, let's bring back the 11 semifinalists.
right. Ladies, you may pick your stool. Whatever stool you may like, please take a seat.
Whatever ladies, seat you like.
No. All right, not in competition order. Are they in competition order? Let's shake it up. Let's move around
move
a little
around.
Bit. Let's get in a random order. Let's get in a more random order. Everybody just play a little musical chairs tonight. Okay. Okay, we're
all right.
Random. We're random tonight. All right. Now, ladies, you may pick your stool and take a seat, please. Take a seat, please. So, don't look at your cards yet, please. Okay, some of you already looked. Now, here's how this is gonna work tonight, all right? These are our semifinalists, and they have no idea what's about to happen because we're about to take a departure from decades of questions being fielded on this stage. All right. Now, you guys might think you know what happens for this part of the competition and what has happened for the last over 100 years. But tonight we are switching things up because we are in a new world that moves much faster. So tonight is going to be a lot different. We're going to shake things up. So instead of having the onstage question like you practiced earlier today, tonight we're rolling out what we call Hot Topics in America. A surprise twist for
it's
the
like
first
movie.
Time ever in Miss America history. Yeah, okay. Okay, so here's how this twist is gonna work. On each stool, there was a card with a number placed on it. As you saw, we just shook it up in random order. You guys decided, we didn't decide for you. So nobody has any idea what topic it will be. Now, when we say your name, I want you to show everybody the number on your card. And we will then reveal the video wall that will show us what that hot topic corresponds to. All right, it's gonna correspond to a number. From there, you will have 30 seconds to expound on whatever that topic may be and talk about it in whatever way you see fit. Because when you're Miss America, you could be on stage talking anywhere and anything can happen, so you gotta be able to think on your
feet. They don't look phased at all.
They don't look
phased.
They look excited.
We got this.
All right. So, what do you guys think? What topics should we throw at them? Anybody have a thought?
Any ideas?
Any good topics? You know what? Let's not ask that. We don't want to get ourselves in trouble. So let's stick to the wall. You ready, Nikki?
I'm ready. I'm all ready. Right, audience, are you ready? Ladies, are you ready? That's the important question. Okay. First up is Miss Texas. And this is in competition order, by the way. Miss Texas, Ellie Bro.
Hot topic number 14.
Let's go to the wall.
Let's see what that is. Okay. All right. 30 seconds on the clock. This is a tough one. I'm going to hold the mic for you for the next 30 seconds. Let's put it on the clock. Terrorism.
So my dad has been a police officer for 27 years. And so one of my number one things I talk about is safety. And with my nonprofit organization, Patrol Stories, we help kids understand how to be safe in their schools and outside of their schools. And so I really think as us as a country, we need to understand how to properly know how to be safe in our communities and understand that our police officers are truly here to serve and protect us.
That was Miss Texas, Ellie Bro.
Up next, Miss North Carolina, Taylor Lord.
Number four.
The topic is?
Families. So I see my family over there, and I see my little brother. And the amazing thing about family is that no family is the same. My brother has special needs, and when he was 4 years old, he was run over by a lawnmower. And that changed his life forever. And so, like I said, no family is the same, but the beautiful thing about America is that we all have that in common, and that we can look inside of each other and see the experiences of one another, and we can connect in that way. And I'm so proud to see him here tonight, and knowing how far he has come and how far our family has come through our journey.
You good running with that mic? I'm just going to stay right here. Okay, up next, Miss Indiana, Sydney Bridges, it is your turn.
All right, let's see the card. Number three.
Topic is education. I will never forget when I was 16 years old, my mother looked me in my face and said, hey, there's no money for you to go to college. My dream is to be a pediatric nurse. I am now actively a pediatric nurse, and I will never forget 16-year-old Sydney sitting and saying, Mom, what do I do? But I am so thankful for the Miss America opportunity. I'm so thankful for scholarships, because if it weren't for scholarships, I would not be standing here in front of you today speaking to you as an educated pediatric nurse. And I want to encourage all you guys out here that education is worth it. Education is worth the fight.
That was Sydney Bridges. Next up, Miss Kansas, Courtney Wages. Let's see what number you have. Number nine.
Number nine. The topic is that moolah.
So with my community service initiative, One Vision is Not the Only Vision, we lack resources for the blind and visually impaired, and this is costing us $145 million in economic impact. If crowned the next Miss America, and I need to be the next Miss America, because there is 14.1 million Americans that have some sort of vision impairment, and 70% are unemployed. And to be Miss America, giving them that opportunity, giving them the resources so they can apply that to their education and into the workforce and help our economy. Thank you.
Next is Miss Colorado, Madison Marsh.
The topic is drugs.
I'm going to take a little bit of a different spin on this and talk about cancer therapy and the drugs that can save people's lives. My mom was misdiagnosed for over 2 years with pancreatic cancer, and so she passed away on November 1st, 2018. The new drug therapies that are out there and the type of funding that we have can save people's lives, but right now it's underfunded. Pancreatic cancer is one of the most underfunded cancers in the country, yet it remains the number three cancer killer. These drugs can save people's life and soak in the money, and I wish we would have poured in more, because people like my mom can still be here today. Thank you.
Next up, Miss Maryland, Kennedy Taylor. It is your turn.
Right, Kennedy with number one, and the number one topic is climate change.
This is certainly a major issue in America, but one thing that I've noticed after buying a house this year is that sometimes we recycle things, but they're not actually being recycled. We're not reusing those materials. And in order for us to really address climate change, I think we need to be completely clear about what's going on with what we're recycling. Thank you.
And up next we have homegirl, Miss Florida, Juliet Valle.
All right, let's see what that topic is. Topic 15, which is women.
Well, I think I'm in the perfect scenario to talk about this, because I am surrounded by 10 other incredibly intelligent, beautiful, and committed women, and I could not be more honored to be in their presence. I could not be more honored to be here. If crowned, I would be the first Hispanic Miss America in this organization's 102-year history, La Primera Miss America Hispana. And I not only want to be an inspiration to young Latina women across this country, but all women, because representation matters. And in 2024, diversity, equity, and inclusion is paramount. Thank you so much.
Okay, next up, Miss Rhode Island, Caroline Parente. Show us your number. Oh, here she is. Number 11.
Number 11, which is politics.
I am personally a political science honors thesis candidate at Brown University, so I understand how important it is for young girls to learn that they should form their own political beliefs. And contribute to our political climate by voting. At the same time, I understand that the role of Miss America is a job. When you're a pediatrician, it does not matter what party the person you're treating belongs to. You're there to help people. It's a job. So as Miss America, I would treat it as a job and help people no matter what their political beliefs are.
Nikki, everybody in the audience started getting nervous. Everybody seeing some of these topics, they're like, oh boy, oh, this is gonna be tough.
And none of them are fake.
All of them are just flawlessly just knocking them out the park.
Yeah, it's incredible.
Boy, oh boy, I'm over here sweating for them. I'm like, this could go left at any point. All right, what's up next?
Next up is Miss Kentucky, Mallory Hudson.
All right, what do we have? Number 10. Let's see what it is on our topic wall, nutrition. All right, 30 seconds on the clock.
Nutrition is so important, and especially for our youth in America. This has been something that I've been able to nurture in my full-time position as the Kentucky Proud Spokesperson through the Kentucky Department of Agriculture, as my role as Miss Kentucky. So I have the privilege of going into dozens of schools, hundreds of schools, in my year as Miss Kentucky and talking with Kentucky's kiddos about the importance of shopping local and getting that food, that nutritious food, from farm gate to plate.
Okay, next up, Miss Arkansas, Corey Keller. Show us your number.
What do we have there, Corey? We have, I didn't see it, number 13, technology in America.
I instantly think about supplemental nutrition assistance programs. As an American Heart Association national advocate, I have been able to advocate for increased access to SNAP incentives. Many people are hindered from actually applying to SNAP incentives because they have a lack of resources and a lack of technology. As Miss Arkansas, I have been able to travel the state as the official goodwill ambassador and even to Washington, D.C. to advocate for increased funding for SNAP incentives because it is too late to feed the future when they're grown and they have to take care of themselves. We have to do it now.
We have one more, and finally, Miss New York, Amelia Collins, it's your turn.
With number 8, and that topic is immigration.
I am actually a first-generation American. My dad immigrated here from South Africa, and I am a firm believer that our country needs serious immigration reform. There are so many individuals who are looking at our country as a beacon of hope and a beacon of light, and instead of sending them away, we need to embrace them with open arms and do our best to help them succeed.
Unbelievable. And that is it for the on-stage portion, the competition for the first time ever. Please give them all a round of applause. Wow. Nikki, I must say, we thought we were going to throw them for a loop, and you guys threw us for a loop. You guys can please exit the stage. Thank you so much. Give them all of a round of applause. Thank you.
Great job.
Man, Nikki.
Wow.
Grab
Do you want to answer a question?
Yeah, sit right here in the... I'm just happy that I wasn't up here for those questions. Let me get this for you.
I think we should throw Terrence a number. What do you
think? No. Because if they would ask me some of those questions, Terrence, talk about technology. Well, my Wi-Fi is really not working right now.
These women are totally killing it.
Talk about education. I had a tough time in high school on algebra.
Did you?
The way they were just answering those questions.
I know.
How amazing was that?
I know. They really were incredible.
It was unbelievable. They're killing it.
You want to ask about politics? I have a major in that. You want to ask about? I mean, just
anything. Please talk about animals. Well, I'm actually a dog walker, and I'm like, what is happening here? They are amazing.
I didn't know that. I have a dog.
I'm the top dog walker in the country. What? How are you the top dog walker in the country? It's me.
You know, what you should add to your resume: stand-up comedian. Right? All right.
I gotta move these chairs. Okay. All right.
They gotta move the chairs.
Let us keep two for a minute.
I know it's very comfy here.
Come on, guys. All right. Please give it up for our incredible crew. They have been working tirelessly. All of our cameramen, all of our grips, everybody that's been putting this show on. They're running around and moving things around. JC Productions and the whole team. has just been crushing it tonight.
Yeah, and these women are killing it on stage tonight, but there's so much more to the Miss America opportunity than just the competition, along with the glamour of the crown. Title holders on the local, state, and national levels become ambassadors once they step off the stage. This year, Miss America is proud to partner with the American Heart Association's Go Red for Women initiative to empower the next generation of women to take charge of their health and make a lasting impact on the well-being of the communities on the local, state, and national level through fundraising and awareness. With cardiovascular disease claiming more lives than all forms of cancer, the Miss America opportunity is the perfect platform to help contribute to the fight against heart disease. Let's give them a round of applause.
Please give them a round of applause. In addition, Miss America and the USO will collaborate this year to support the people serving in our nation's military and their families. Now, while this is a new collaboration, this relationship is weaved into the rich history of Miss America. USO Global Entertainment is the gold standard for delivering first-class entertainment programming to U.S. military service members and their families. Partnering with entertainment and sports industries, the USO brings celebrities and athletes to military locations worldwide. Through the USO's global entertainment program, Miss America and Miss America's team will be provided opportunities to be a part of events with and for the military community. So once again, thank you.
Okay, switching things up. No, we're not switching things up.
You're not?
No.
We should take a moment?
Yeah.
While they're getting ready backstage?
Yeah, I think they're still getting ready backstage.
I think it has been one of those nights. We have our judges who have been working. If all of our judges, I want one word to describe how it feels in here and judging tonight. What do you think?
Electrifying.
Electrifying. It's an electrifying evening. Cynthia.
Empowering.
Empowering.
Love that.
Absolutely magical.
Absolutely mad. One word. We crunched it together. Magical.
Is that one
I love
word?
It.
Was that one
David,
word?
For you, anything.
Word. Inspiring.
I'm inspired.
Motivating.
Motivating, to say the least.
Sensational.
Sensational.
Okay. Now I want the audience on the count of three to all shout out a word. Ready? One, two, three. Why did I hear Happy New Year?
I did hear a lot. All right, right now, while the contestants are getting ready, we want to know a little bit more about where everybody is from. So who came from really far here tonight? Who came from the farthest? We have some people from Hawaii.
Oh, this is fun. Yeah, this is fun.
She's just holding up her sign.
This little catwalk, this
yeah.
is fun. We can see you.
Where are
all.
You from? Alabama. Okay, where? Texas? Where?
Texas is always representing.
All right, okay. And where are you guys from up top? PA is
PA.
Here? Pennsylvania?
Somebody's from a galaxy far, far away. I see a lightsaber up there.
Where? Oklahoma.
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 What do we got over here?
Colorado. Where do you? Florida. What's your, hold up. All right, so have you been to one of these competitions before? So how does it feel to have this magic here in Florida? How does it feel?
Inspiring.
She's inspired. Are you inspired? I know I'm inspired.
I think this we whole have some future is, Miss Americas down here.
I can see that.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And where Nebraska?
Nebraska's making
what's
some noise in the back.
What's the best restaurant I need to eat at if I come to Nebraska? Where do I get some food?
What Texas, I want to know what barbecue
Bubba's.
To go
what?
To. What barbecue do I
where?
Go to, Texas?
I can't hear what they're saying. Arkansas. Arkansas came in here like gangbusters. They came to take things up. And is anybody here celebrating a birthday? Do we have any birthday people? We have a happy birthday here.
Anybody want to get engaged 42? Right here, right
no
now?
No way. Four days ago. Okay, 4 days ago. 22. All right.
Happy birthday.
Here with the family.
Want you.
All right, and where else? What did you say? Kentucky. Kentucky didn't come to play.
We have a birthday here tomorrow.
You have a birthday.
What birthday are we celebrating?
Could you please stand up for us, sir? We want to talk to you, man. He is cool as a fan. He's like, I am at my 30th pageant. Sir, what's your name? I usually don't hand over my mic because sometimes you don't get it back, but you're going to hand it back to me, right? All right.
My new co-host.
Tell us your name and where you're from and how old you are this birthday.
I'm Bob Clark. I'm in the iron and steel business. My sister irons and me and my son-in-law steel. And I'm from Tampa, Florida.
And sir, do you mind me asking, it's your birthday coming up. How old are you going to be?
I hate to admit it, but I will be 86 on Monday.
86 years old.
Congratulations and happy birthday.
Well, Bob, I know it's your 86th birthday. I know you've been, but tonight I'm taking you out to the club. Me and you, we're going to the club in Orlando. We're going to have a good time, all right, sir? We're going to get some drinks. We're going to have a good time. Just trust me, all right? I'll have the car service pull up to the side, bring the whole family. No, matter of fact, leave the family at home, you and me, tonight. I'll see you later. Bob's 86th birthday.
He knows birthday. The spots. He knows
just trust
the spots.
Me, Bob.
You're not going to get
Bob,
a lot of
trust me,
tonight.
All right? I'll see you later tonight. All right. Are you ready to do this, Nikki?
I am ready for this. All right. That was first-class entertainment. But speaking of first-class entertainment, are you ready to see some incredible talent on this stage? I don't know. Are you ready? I couldn't hear that.
While we talk about talent, y'all give it up for us. Y'all never seen nobody fill time like that. Look how we filled that time. That was professional time filling right there. Crushed it.
All right. Now I think they've had enough of our entertainment.
Yep, let's do it.
Which is good because these ladies are ready to leave it all on stage tonight. The talent competition is a long-standing Miss America tradition that displays artistry, creativity, and stage presentation. And our semi-finalists are continuing that tradition tonight. Performing a rhythmic gymnastics routine to hold my hand is Miss Texas, Ellie Bro.
Hold my hand, everything will be okay. I heard from the heavens that clouds have been gray. Pull me close, wrap me in your aching arms. I see that you're hurting. Why'd you take so long to tell me you need me? I see that you're bleeding. You don't need.
Texas Ellie Bro.
performing the aria Amour Ranime Mon Courage. That was my French. Here is Miss North Carolina, Taylor Lord.
Was Miss North Carolina, Taylor Lloyd. Next to the stage, singing I'll Be There, please welcome Miss Indiana, Sydney Bridges.
Bring salvation back where there is love. I'll be there. I'll reach out my hand to you. I love faith in all you do. Whenever you need me, I'll be there.
Dancing to shake your groove thing is Miss Kansas, Courtney Wages.
Yeah.
That was Miss Kansas, Courtney Wages. Please give her another round of applause. And now, here to give you her story based on determination and grit, please welcome Miss Colorado, Madison Marsh.
Tower, this is Skyhawk 707 Tango Mike at Charlie South, ready to take off on a runway 25. It's my first solo flight, and I am in charge. I'm the pilot in command of this aircraft. For the tower, this little plane is known as Skyhawk 707 Tango Mike. I'm flying at 3,000 feet, and there's no instructor here to check my speed, altitude, or runway spacing. I'm 16 years old, and I alone must rely on my training, instinct, and determination. Flying over my high school, I see the clouds getting darker. Heavy rain begins to pound the windshield, and Tango Mike begins to shake with turbulence. I've flown in these stormy conditions before, but never, never have I done it alone. But failure is not an option, and fear has no place in the cockpit. So I remain calm, and I talk myself through the landing checklist. As my wheels gently touch the runway, I've done it! I've earned my pilot's license at the youngest possible age. It's been more than 6 years since that first solo flight, and I'm now an active duty officer for the United States Air Force. Whether I'm seated in the cockpit or standing in my crown, I know the sky is not the limit. Tower, this is Second Lieutenant Marsh, inbound for landing.
Now, here to perform a Latin ballroom dance, the conga. Please welcome Miss Marilyn Kennedy Taylor.
Come on, shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. Come on, shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer.
Now here to sing Sempre Libera from Verdi's La Traviata is Miss Florida, Juliet Valle.
Sempre libera di Gio folleggiare di gioia in gioia vo che scorre viver mio per sentieri di lascia giorno giorno moia sempre l'età ne ritrovi voi ti sempre nuovi ne volare il mio pensiero di volare di volare di volare il mio pensiero
That was Miss Florida, Juliet Valle, here to sing Imagine is Miss Rhode Island, Caroline Parente.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us, above us only sky. Imagine all the people living life in peace. Imagine no possession. For greed or hunger, a brotherhood of men. Imagine all the people sharing all the world. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only.
Caroline Parente.
I see you have a handbag. This is beautiful.
Well, you know, a lady can't go anywhere without her handbag, Terrence.
What are you keeping that thing?
My whole world is in
the
here.
The whole world is in that thing.
Yes. All right. So my name's Nikki, and this is Creations by Nikki. She has been so generous, gifting some of the judges, the winners, myself. You're going to need one for your fiance, by the way.
I'm
going
to need one. Let me see what's in there. Open this thing.
Oh, you want to look inside?
Yeah,
you never asked to look inside a woman's handbag.
I'm sorry.
But you can look.
I don't even want to look at this point. I don't know what could
just
be
don't,
in there.
Don't show anybody. Anyway, it says boss lady. I feel like a boss tonight.
Very cute. Very sparkly. I absolutely love it. Creations by Nikki, all right?
Thank you.
How are
Thank
you feeling
you
right
so
now,
generous.
Nikki?
Because kind of like a boss, to be honest with you.
This whole competition is amazing, and it's time for the next contestant.
Yes, it is. Here to sing I Who Have Nothing, please welcome Miss Kentucky, Mallory Hudson.
To working. Please welcome Miss Arkansas, Corey Keller.
Texas, Arkansas, Corey Keller. Okay, finally, here to perform a commercial jazz dance medley for the girls. We run this. Here is Miss New York, Amelia Collins.
So deep in your eyes, I love on you more and more every time. When you leave, I'm begging you not to go. Call your name two or three times in a row. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your lies got me looking so crazy right now. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your lies got me looking so crazy right now.
Organizations and the delegates on the local, state, and national levels spend their year of service promoting the causes these spectacular groups stand for. Best Buddies International, a global nonprofit organization, and Miss America are thrilled to announce an impactful partnership committed to promoting inclusion and empowering people with intellectual and developmental disabilities. This collaboration is designed to foster lasting and positive change to create a world of inclusion. Members will proudly serve as global ambassadors for Best Buddies to create awareness about the Best Buddies mission, as well as the power of the crown as a greater platform for philanthropy. Please give a round of applause for our partnership with Big Best Buddies International.
Thank you, thank you. Now, Miss Felicia, is your role back? Everybody's back? They're back, okay, because it's time for the big part of the competition. We didn't want to do that unless everybody was back in their seats. Now, you've all seen the fitness, you've seen the talents, and you've seen the intellect of these 11 semifinalists. But right now, it's time for the glamour. Miss America makes many different types of appearances all year long, but those red carpet and black tie events are where they can showcase the style and sophistication and what it's all about with the evening wear and some of those most iconic moments. So, with a backdrop of individual glamour, first, we're gonna do something very special. We are going to have a Giovanni Gala video. So, take a look at that. Giovanni with those iconic looks, they look amazing. How do the dresses feel? How does it feel? Because you're working, you're moving, but you're looking fantastic.
It's like floating. It's a little bit like floating. You move, it moves with you. It's wonderful. Giovanni, the best. Thank you.
Right. And what a night it's been. Again, thank you so much. I believe it was over 102 dresses that they donated for the first part of the competition. So what an amazing feat and what an amazing weekend that it's been.
Yes, I was at the gala on Friday night and seeing everybody in red. We were all dressed in red and it was absolutely spectacular. I don't know how you put together all those red dresses, but you did it.
You know, and with a backdrop of individual glamorous evening gown images captured by our official photographer, Carlos Velez, in gowns of their choosing, may we present to you the top 11 semifinalists in the evening gown competition, brought to you again by our fashion partner, Giovanni.
First up is Miss Texas, Ellie Rowe.
There's a lot of power in the word yes. Had I not said yes, I wouldn't be on this stage. Had I not said yes, I wouldn't have graduated almost debt-free from a D1 university. Say yes to the Miss America opportunity. It'll change your life just like it did mine.
Welcome, Miss North Carolina, Taylor Lord.
Because of the women who walked before me in my shoes, I not only stand taller in my own, but empower the next generation of women.
Defying the odds that have been stacked against me, and it is my life mission to inspire others to do the same.
Say hello to Miss Kansas, Courtney Wages.
The Miss America opportunity transformed my life by leading me to a career in public service, helping transform the lives of the blind and visually impaired. It's a new day at Miss America, and I am committed to continuing my service by extending the same opportunity I've been given to everyone I come in contact with.
Next
because of my mom. I lost her to pancreatic cancer when she was only 41 years old. But now I stand here 5 years later, taller and stronger in her memory. This one's for you, Mama.
Taylor.
As a woman in cybersecurity, I worked hard to earn a seat at the table. With the tools I learned from the Miss America opportunity, I am ready to own the table and empower women to be bold and lead the way.
Is Miss Florida, Juliet Valle.
It's hard to be her if you can't see her. This is why I am determined to break barriers and make history by becoming the first Hispanic Miss America in 102 years. My journey is not just about pursuing a title. It's about inspiring and empowering young women everywhere.
By the notion that femininity and power are not adversaries. They're partners crafting a narrative of strength and grace.
Say hello to Miss Kentucky, Mallory Hudson.
I am in competition with no one. The only person I'm trying to be better than is the Mallory I was yesterday.
I wore my evening gown, I was winning the title of Miss Arkansas, and my biggest fan was in an ICU bed recovering from emergency open heart surgery. Tonight, my dad is here with us, and I walk the stage in honor of him and all heart disease survivors.
Finishing closing out the evening gown portion of the competition is Miss New York, Amelia Collins.
There is nothing more beautiful than someone who goes out of their way to make life beautiful for others. Success isn't just about what you accomplish in life, it's about what you inspire others to do.
Spellbinding. That was spellbinding. People are nodding. Yes, that was. That was absolutely spectacular. Okay, let's give another round of applause for our top 11 in evening gown. And with that, we have finished the semifinal competition.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are dangerously close to revealing the top five finalists who still have a shot at becoming Miss America 2024. But before we do, let's take a look at all of the exciting activities the delegates have been up to all week long here in Orlando.
The Miss America competition definitely gives these ladies memories to last a lifetime. We would like to thank Passion Roses. They will be presenting the runners-up with gorgeous bouquets grown in the savanna of Bogota, Colombia. Thank you to Passion Roses.
And this year's crowning moment will be full of the magic of both the present and the past. Miss America 2024 will be given a stunning array of roses presented by Nikki Six with Bouquet Box.
Also, we are so excited to announce that this year, along with the crowned sash and bouquet, we are bringing back the magic to the coronation of Miss America 2024 with the donning of the iconic coronation robe that defined the crowning moments of Miss America from years past. Yes. Giovanni Fashions has generously designed and created an immaculate couture update of this relic in contemporary style with the inclusion, I love this part, of 20,000 tulle roses. So once again, thank you to Giovanni for your amazing partnership with Miss America.
Bringing the robe back along with the crown and the roses, it's going to be a night to remember. I'm so excited about that.
I am too. Can't wait to see it. And now, performing for you tonight, Kauai signature artist, Ethan Elias, with Disney's A Whole New World.
Ethan Elias, everyone.
Ethan Elias. Please give him a round of applause.
Thank you, Ethan. And what a beautiful piano that is.
Uh-oh, here he goes.
And for your next performer. You're going to say, okay, just take it, just take it, just take it, just take it. All right.
He was about to have a moment.
Which
is
ordinary people.
We see you don't need a piano.
Yeah, I know. I was going to get into it. Yeah, you missed out. You guys missed out on a nice number. We would like to take the time to thank Ethan and everyone at Kauai for providing those beautiful pianos that you've seen on stage this entire week and for that generous contribution to our preliminary talent scholarships. They are a storied and history part of the program, almost as old as Miss America. Founded in 1927, Kauai has grown to become one of the largest and best known musical instrument companies in the world, offering a complete line of pianos, digital pianos, and professional keyboards for musicians across the United States and Canada. So again, a big thanks to Kauai.
Huge thank you, and that was so beautiful.
All right, are you ready? You ready? You feel
it? Let me think about it.
Well, if we're going to get into...
I mean, as the audience, are you ready?
You guys ready?
Do you know what you're ready for? Do you know what we're going to do right here, right now?
Yeah, let's bring her out. It's time to announce the winner. We're going to bring out Allison. Allison has the envelopes. Allison.
We are going to announce the top five finalists once again. Allison Philippone.
Okay, and now Allison, has seen this, right? All right, Allison and her team at EY, they got this locked down tight.
Okay. Whew. Yeah, now my heart's pounding again. Okay, the names we announce are the top five delegates who will be moving on to the final phase of competition on stage question. Are you ready?
I am ready. Cue the dramatic music. Ooh, it's music.
Who's it gonna be?
Gonna be the chills.
Okay, here we go. Your top five finalists in random order are
Miss Rhode Island!
The state of Indiana, Sydney Bridges.
All right. Right now, it's getting down to the wire. Right now, I'm more nervous than Santa Claus on his first Christmas Eve. Time for the next semi-finalist, who comes from Kentucky. Miss Kentucky is a finalist in our top five, Mallory Hudson. can feel it. You can feel it in the room. Right now, the tension feels immense. All of the late nights, all of the early mornings, all of the hard work, all of the tears, all of the dedication comes down to this next moment. The final delegate to make it into our top five is Miss Texas Ellie Rose. To everybody in our top 11, thank you, thank you, thank you. Amazing work.
Congratulations.
Amazing work. Thank you all.
We applaud you, ladies, for your outstanding work. Ladies and gentlemen, your top five finalists for Miss America 2024.
You know what? Guys, switch sides, switch sides.
Switch sides.
Switch sides.
Switch sides. Yeah.
Take the moment. Take the moment.
Make some noise for these amazing finalists.
All right. Okay. Without further ado, I hope you all are ready to answer some questions. Let's get right to it. Right. Now again, everything that's happened before does not dictate what happens now. It is all on the line. All right. First up is Miss Rhode Island. Caroline, please step up to the mic. Caroline, if you were chosen as Miss America, what social media campaign would you launch?
I would show young girls across the country that femininity and power can and should coexist. I personally feel as though females in entrepreneurship is one of the most crucial components that we can incorporate, because women actually possess qualities that make them more successful as CEOs. So one initiative I would launch is showing girls that they should embrace the qualities that make them feminine, because those are the qualities that make them stronger. Thank you.
Thank you. Sydney Bridges, Miss Indiana, please step forward. If you were crowned Miss America tonight, what do you want to be known for?
I want to be known for leaving a legacy of impact, but also leaving a legacy of authenticity. Too often, pageant women don't share what's really going on in their life. And I believe that when we stand strong in the fact that we're not perfect, that we're flawed, and the fact that we have bad days, we also have amazing days, we can get more women involved in the Miss America opportunity. At the end of the day, I want someone to see me and say, I can be her. I never want someone to see me and say, I can never be her. We are here to stand strong in our authenticity and stand strong in who we are, to get more women involved in this organization. Thank you.
Thank you. Miss Kentucky, Mallory Hudson. Now, Mallory, if you were chosen as Miss America, how would you connect with the general public?
I believe that I can connect with the general public in numerous ways, one of which being my service initiative, Inclusive Stages, which is an opportunity in itself. Inclusive Stages is designed to provide theatrical and artistic opportunities for individuals with special learning needs and disabilities. I truly believe that I can connect with every American, whether or not that's in person or through social media. I want individuals to be able to visit Miss America's platforms and feel an instant connection connection with her, and I want to reach as many Americans as possible in my year as Miss America 2024.
Thank you. Miss Colorado, Madison Marsh. How has your career equipped you to be our next Miss America?
So right now, I am second Lieutenant Marsh. That would make me the very first military member to ever win Miss America. Graduating from the Air Force Academy has enabled me with the skills to lead, to learn, and lead with passion across our nation. Being the president of the Whitney Marsh Foundation that I started after my mom has equipped me with those same skills to inspire and educate people about pancreatic cancer, to inspire people to be the next, to break stereotypes and break boundaries, and that is exactly what I would do as Second Lieutenant Marsh and Miss America.
And rounding off the top five is Miss Texas, Ellie Bro. Now, if you were chosen as Miss America, what would you do with this opportunity?
So I always say that I am a unifier. I always think that we have been divided for so long. My dad's a police officer, my mom's a teacher, and my mission as Miss America is to unify our nation. Our communities need to understand our police officers, but also our police officers need to understand the communities that they're serving in. And that is what America needs. America needs a unifier, and I am that unifier to bring our nation together.
Thank you, ladies. Please give it up for your top five. Let's give them another round of applause. Now you guys can exit the stage, and we will see you all momentarily. Thank you again.
These ladies are so well-spoken and charismatic. I would not want to be a judge right now, that's for sure. How about you?
They have the hardest job in the house. Again, thank you so much to our judges. Thank you to EY for putting it all together. And right now, it is time for a very special part of the night. We are beyond fortunate to have so many forever Miss Americas who have returned to be a part of bringing back the magic. So please welcome to the stage and join us in celebrating our forever Miss Americas here tonight. Starting with Miss America 1963, Jacqueline Meyer. We love you, Jacqueline. 1963.
Oh man, Terrence, I'm already crying. Okay. Miss America 1965, Vonda K. Van Dyke.
Welcome, Miss America 1974, Rebecca Ann King.
And now Miss America 1981, Susan Powell.
Thank you.
join us in welcoming Miss America 1987, Miss Kelly Cash.
And now, Miss America 1995, Heather Whitestone.
Miss America 1999, Nicole Johnson.
Miss America 2000, Heather French.
Let's celebrate Miss America 2004, Erica Dunlap.
And now Miss America 2009, Katie Stamp.
Miss America 2018, Cara Mund.
And finally, Miss America 2020, Camille Schreier.
That was amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for our forever Miss Americas. What a special moment that is. And while we talk about special moments, we have to talk about a special person. We would be remiss to not acknowledge the new CEO of Miss America, Robin Fleming, who's here tonight with her incredible family. Is Robin here? Robin. Give it up for Robin, ladies and gentlemen. Robin, what a magical evening. Is your vision coming to life the way you imagined it?
You know, I think that it's hard not to be magical when you're in such a marvelous city such as the city of Orlando. And I just really want to thank the Dr. Phillips Center and the Walt Disney Theater crew. They have been amazing. So yes, do I think it's been magical tonight? I don't know. Do you think it's been magical tonight?
Are you ready for a new Miss America in 2024?
You know, Grace has been a remarkable title holder throughout her year. She has was named by Wall Street Journal as the face of nuclear energy. She is Forbes 30 under 30 in the science space. She's been amazing. And I know we're gonna see great things from her as she moves ahead in her career. She's gonna be a spokesperson. She has so many speaking engagements lined up. So I think that's kind of, I'm not ready for a new Miss America, but I know it's time for a new Miss America. It is 2024 after all. So yes, I'm excited to find out who's going to wear the crown this year.
All right, well, we are excited as well. Robin, again, it takes so much to put a program like this on. So congratulations to you. Thank you to your entire team. Please give it up for Robin one more time.
We salute you. We love you, Robin. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Robin made so many amazing decisions to make a night like tonight happening,
she
like hiring us.
Has.
Great job, Robin.
Thanks. How incredible has this night been so far? All thanks to this woman and her team.
Yeah.
Another incredible woman, though, is moments away from joining that revered group of forever Miss Americas. So before we crown Miss America 2024, let's show our gratitude and appreciation for a young woman who wore the crown with incredible dignity, poise, and charisma this past year. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss America 2023, Grace Stanky.
The past year as Miss America was certainly an experience I will never forget. From wearing a hard hat just as much as I wore the crown, I am honored to have represented the women who can. Women who can dream. Women who can lead. Women who can do whatever they set their minds to, including being a nuclear engineer and Miss America. After traveling to 23 states and appearances in 8 countries, with gaining pretty good status on multiple airlines, I am so thankful for each and every conversation, speech, and appearance that I had. Throughout this year, I have learned that it's Miss America that people approach, but it's me as Grace who listens and makes them feel welcomed, heard, and appreciated. While I love giving speeches, I have learned that listening is more important throughout this year. However, I do have a few things left to say and many thanks to give out, so you'll just have to listen to me for just a little bit longer. To Brenda, Megan, Tara, Caitlin, and everyone at Miss Wisconsin who helped me get to this point, thank you. The skills I needed to become Miss America came from my time with you. Morgan, you never cease to amaze me, and I have loved learning all about the theater world from you. I can't wait to have my next Broadway education session with you. To Caroline, Liz, Teresa, and Kathy, this year would not have happened without your leadership, friendship, and trust. Thank you. Thank you to my family and friends, Mom, Dad, Zach, Andrea, my extended family, and the Vanderhuis for supporting me throughout this experience. You dealt with the tears, the joy, the off days, and the on days, and I couldn't have done it without you. To the next Miss America, you were chosen for a reason. You were chosen for who you are and the skills you have. Use them, stay true to yourself, and be strong. With this, in the year of Barbie, Oppenheimer, Beyonce, Taylor Swift, and the start of a new generation of nuclear scientists and engineers, I am proud of my year as Miss America 2023. Closing this chapter and thrilled for the next. I am Miss America 2023, Grace Stanky.
Ovation. Grace, thank you. You are truly a gem. Thank you for being such an amazing Miss America ambassador this past year. Grace Stanky, Miss America 2023, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
Absolutely love her. Got to chat with her the last few days, and she is incredible. She was
phenomenal.
Giving advice backstage to the delegates. She's incredible. All right, though. As we come to the close of the competition, we welcome back all 51 delegates in a glamorous display of Giovanni evening wear. Here is the parade of gowns.
Wake up and breathing deeper than yesterday. Take on the morning like your soul's been remade. Roll down the windows, let your cares fly away. Good things are yours to claim, you don't have to wait. All across the sky, new mercies rise, and the future's bright. This is a new day. Everything bursting with hope, coming alive. This moment, you got a freedom. No looking back anymore. Open your eyes, it's coming. This is a new day. The old is gone away. This is a new day.
on you. Love hasn't given up on you. Love is making the old things new today and every single day. Love hasn't given up on you. Love hasn't given up on you. Love, yeah.
One, two, three.
Miss America 2024. What a night.
You ready to go clubbing? You still awake? You ready?
Yeah. Bob is ready. He is. We all came here for you, okay? Yes. They all got dressed.
Should we sing happy birthday? No.
Yeah, okay. Now, at the start of tonight's show, we narrowed the field down from 51 to 11. And for the first time ever, all 11 started tonight's final with a blank slate and an equal chance at the crown. Now, we saw them here fiercely compete in the on-stage conversation. We saw the fitness, we saw the talent, and we saw the evening gown. And I don't know how they did it, but our judges have narrowed it down from 51 to 11 to 5 to now 1.
And now, the moment these ladies have been working toward. We are ready to take it from 5 to 1. If the judges and auditors are ready, please welcome back Allison Philippone with the results. Thank you, Allison.
All right, again, a special thanks to Allison and the team of auditors at EY who have been here all week long doing an amazing job tabulating for us. It's time.
Audience, are you ready? Ladies, are you ready? Here we go. Your fourth runner-up is Miss Rhode Island, Caroline Parente.
Thank you.
it's time to announce the third runner-up. Congratulations to Miss Kentucky, Mallory Hudson.
America 2024.